This is a poinsettia. You can find these at the store during the holiday season, and it's the typical holiday plant that you can find at the stores, and they generally run a few bucks. But if you wait until right around Christmas time, they're practically throwing them out the door because nobody wants them when it's right at Christmas or right after Christmas. Or if you want to save some money and be really frugal, tell your friends, when you're done with Christmas, can I have your poinsettia? Thing is, these are extremely beautiful indoor houseplants. Make sure your kid doesn't eat it because it's poisonous. Make sure your dog doesn't eat it. It's poisonous. Basically, don't feed your houseplants to your animals and don't stick them in your mouth. It's very simple. This is not a flower, by the way. The red is not a flower. The red is nothing more than leaves that have turned red because they reduce the amount of light to this plant. When you do that, the leaves start turning red on top, and then eventually all the leaves start falling off. That's why your poinsettia kind of falls apart right around Christmas time, because it's basically dying. What you do is after Christmas, you prune it back like I do with my pepper plants. It starts sending out these big branches and big green leaves. And believe it or not, this will be such a showpiece in your house after Christmas. People will look at it and go, my gosh, what the heck is that? And you go, it's a poinsettia. Yes, it's a poinsettia, and it will be absolutely huge. They get monstrous. And I will grow this for you in my house and show you what a poinsettia can do when it's not entertaining you for Christmas. So for just a couple bucks or for free, you can have a plant that puts out like crazy. And then next Christmas, if you want to, put it in a closet, give it reduced light, and then your big honking poinsettia turns red again, and you have this insanely huge, and I'm talking this big, I'm not just putting my arms up here because it's fun, you will have this insanely huge red poinsettia, bigger than anything you can find at the store, and you got it free. Ah. So anyway, poinsettia, same thing with something that you get for St. Patrick's Day. This is a shamrock. And I got this at Walmart because, you know, they have these little teeny tiny potted shamrocks right around St. Patrick's Day. Just like they have the little itty bitty roses and stuff like that for Valentine's Day. I got this on Valentine's Day, and it's this little itty bitty teeny tiny plant. And I grew it and I thought it would die. Nope, it didn't die. It got bigger and bigger, and I had to transplant it twice. Now I have this big, huge shamrock that's been flowering all year long. It's an extremely beautiful indoor plant. And no special care whatsoever. Just dump some water on it every now and then, and I have a shamrock. Same thing with the Christmas cactus. Christmas cactuses you'll get around Christmas, and they're basically at a premium price. Wait till the Christmas season is either over or just about over. You'll notice the stores will be knocking these things down in price, and you can get them almost for nothing. And you can grow this inside year-round, and it's an extremely beautiful plant. People will see this during the summer in your house and go, oh my gosh. Everybody that sees this on these programs, they're just stunned by how beautiful this plant can be. I'm not a wizard when it comes to growing this thing. I have no idea what I'm doing. All I know is I dump water in, I give it a little bit of light each day. I don't give it anything special, not underneath this crazy grow room condition. I put it in a southern window that gets partial light during the day, and that's all I do. That's all I do. 5 years after I got this thing, look at it go. And this thing is not a holiday plant, but there's something strange going on. And since I'm not doing a voodoo garden program this week, because I want to take a little bit of time off for the holidays, I thought I would bring in a little something strange onto the Praxis channel and show you, because it's not a holiday thing, but it is a fun little thing, a little doodah dragon fruit. And I got it as a little nub from a seller on eBay. And then in no time at all, it put up these two little arms like that. And now it's got a little third arm. So it's really kind of crazy. But look at what the little third arm is doing. What do you think? Roots? That's what I'm thinking. And it's got one up here on that. And if you turn it over here, whoops, there's one right here. I'm assuming if I snip this thing off right there, it will root, whatever. You know what I mean? Let's do it right now. Go, ah! There we go. Yikes. I just know I'm gonna get little cactus thingies in my fingers. Ah, I should be using tweezers. What am I thinking? Okay, you get in like that. I don't know, is that right? I don't know, it looks right. Well, I guess we'll find out, won't we? But and by the way, the potting mix that I use is absolutely nothing special. It is half generic potting mix that I get at the store. It's kind of like a generic version of Miracle-Gro. Yeah, nothing special. It just has like, I don't know, peat moss, shredded sticks, toenails, a tongue. You know, just stupid stuff. And there's no nutrients whatsoever. It's like 0.00 or something like that. There really is nothing in this stuff. But it's cheap. And that's what I need because I use so much of it. I use half that, half cocoa peat, which is coir, that shredded coconut stuff. That has no nutrients. And then I sprinkle in a very liberal amount of vermiculite. So basically, I have a soil that is nothing. And what makes my plants grow well is I use an organic fertilizer. You can use organic, inorganic, whatever you want. You control the amount of feed that your plants get. And that, along with a little bit of light and a little bit of common sense, is what can turn a failure into something like a success. And that's what I have here is a success because I have no life. I spend all my time up here with my plants. So, yes, all of this is actually thanks to my stupidity, my willingness to make a fool of myself, my willingness to mess things up, to learn something from my mistakes, and also to have you post your comments. I don't ask you to post your comments because I enjoy seeing a ton of comments. I have you post your comments because I like to read them. And every now and then something gets into my empty head and it sticks there. And you'll see me talking about something and you go, I'm the one who posted that. Yes, it's because of you that I have so much in here and I have so much going on up here to help the next person in line. So for that, I thank you so much. And in the spirit of rambling on and just going on about nothing, I would like to extend a welcome to Luke from the Micro Garden channel. And Luke is an old friend, and those of you who have tuned in for a long time, you know the whole history of Luke being my friend, Luke and I having our problems, and eventually Luke and I realizing that we were both buttheads, and we are trying to repair a friendship that we've had for a long time, and it's going extremely well. It's going extremely well. And Luke has something going on, and I didn't tell him I'm gonna do this, so this is kind of gonna be a surprise to him too. I want to announce that he has a brand spanking new channel. And you know, he has the Am I Gardener channel, Grow Big or Shut Up or something. Sorry, Luke. No, he has a channel that says Grow Big or Go Home. And that's wonderful. He does really great on that. But he came up with a genius idea, and I have to admit it, it's genius, it is. He has something that went the exact opposite. He has something called the micro garden. And you know me, I like to grow all kinds of strange and bizarre things up here in the voodoo garden. But he decided that he wants to take certain plants and keep them small. For people that have small spaces, you have not a whole lot of room like I do. You don't have a whole room to dedicate to growing. You don't have a house. You may have an apartment. You may have a very small apartment. You may live in a closet. Well, if you live in a closet, you're pretty cramped. And you're not going to have all the room in the world to grow everything that you want to grow. So he has a great idea. Why not grow small? Grow small and grow it healthy. And that's where he came up with the idea for the micro garden. And he bounced it off me and I thought, I can't believe this. This is wonderful. I've not seen this anywhere on YouTube. It's extremely original, extremely good. And he is gonna do a good job on this. He has a whole bunch of plants coming in. Dwarf papayas, dwarf fruit trees, dwarf pomegranates, even dwarf vegetables. He's gonna grow vegetables and keep them pruned back so that you can do stuff in your house or on a patio outside. So for all of this, I would like to wish him the best of luck and to shamelessly spam his new channel here on the Praxis channel because I think it's gonna be a good thing and I want to be in on this this good thing right at the beginning and to wish him well and to also let you guys know that he has something good going on. So if you wanna check it out, name's up here, name's down in the description down there. Best of luck, Luke, you have my support. You have the support of anybody who wants to grow something and wants to grow it small. So anyway, that pretty much wraps it up for here. I'm gonna go ahead and transplant this, but I'm not gonna do it on camera because that's some me time with me and my plants. It keeps me sane. Well, it keeps me as sane as I can possibly be. But anyway, thank you so much for tuning into the Praxis 55712 channel for this last episode before Thanksgiving. Yes, I won't be doing any more videos until after Thanksgiving because I have a homemade pie to make out of the apples that I grew off my tree. And I have a homemade pumpkin pie to make from the pumpkin that I grew out in my garden. And I have a very angry dead turkey in my fridge that I'm going to be dealing with in a couple days. But I wanted to do one last episode for you right here, right now, before the holiday season. But after the holiday season, guess what? Guess what? I will be announcing the 2013 free seed giveaway. I will be shamelessly touching my microphone. I will be shamelessly promoting it all through December. So stay tuned. And also, please visit Luke over at the Micro Garden. He really is doing a fun thing over there. I'm a big fan of his. And so when I'm excited about something, I want to bring it to your attention too. I think you're going to enjoy it because he has some great ideas. And also, one of the nice things about it is he is absolutely open to our ideas. So a couple things that I might be growing here, I'm going to try and give him as many tips as I can to help him along. But I think he pretty much has a handle on it. I think he does. I think he really does. Anyway, I'm so so caffeinated right now. I don't know. I think I'll just start chopping plants up and have a good time up here. But last thing I want to mention is, with the grow room being as crowded as it is right now and kind of pushing me off to the side, I have some plans and I think you're going to like it. It involves me doing something downstairs that I haven't done before. So you're going to have to stay tuned for that. A lot of good things happening in December and January and all throughout the next year here on the Praxis channel and the Voodoo Garden channel and Luke's Micro Garden channel. So stay tuned. It isn't going to be a boring winter. It isn't going to be boring winter whatsoever. You're going to be entertained. You're going to have fun. I think I'm going to go. Thanks everybody for tuning in and have a great Thanksgiving. I really do appreciate you tuning in. Have a good day, everybody. Bye.